Hey everyone, welcome back to Daily Devotions. Pastor Steve here. Was going to be outside because we're now in the fruit of gentleness, but it's not too gentle outside as we're embracing a tropical storm right now. But we thank you for joining us again and being able to walk in God's Word. As I do each week, I want to start off the fruit of the Spirit, where the fruit of the Spirit is talked about in Galatians chapter 5, being able to get back to this repetition of what these nine virtues of the fruit of the Spirit are. We are in gentleness, get gentleness this week, and then self-control next week. We've walked through 9 weeks of the fruit of the Spirit. So thanks again for being patient and walking alongside. Let's open up to Galatians chapter 5 once again and be able to uncover, start our week off about what this word truly means. And so Galatians chapter 5, beginning at verse 16. Verse 16, we walk through life by the Spirit, but also life of the flesh, life of sin as well. So it says, verse 16 of chapter 5 from Galatians, "So I say, live by the Spirit, and you will not gratify the desires of the sinful nature. For the sinful nature desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit what is contrary to the sinful nature." A battle going on. "They are in conflict with each other, so that you do not do what you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. The acts of the sinful nature are obvious: sexual immorality, impurity and debauchery, idolatry and witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fits of rage, selfish ambition, dissensions, factions, and envy, drunkenness, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the sinful nature with its passions and desires. And since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking, and envying each other. For the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness." How's that gentleness word, and what does he mean? Paul, as he's writing to this church, this region of churches in Galatia, he's really speaking to a role they take. Gentleness. Now, we would see gentleness as being nice, as being precautionary, a gentleness. But really, this is the word. It's only used to this word in the New Testament. It's used as meekness. Meekness. And I got that pulled up here. It says that being meek, having meekness, is quiet, gentle, and easily imposed on. But this word that's next is really the descriptive word of gentleness or meekness. Submissive. That word is taken so out of context in our society today. Submissive means weak. Submissive means imposed on, as it's talking about here. Gentleness means that this just kind of a rollover, just a mat people walk on. But that's not what Paul means here in Galatians chapter 5. He means submissive. He means meek. He means gentleness, yes, but within a context that is actually amazing and powerful. So here it is, meekness, submissive, to know our role. When you are submissive and it's negative in our society, it's like looked down upon, but submissive is what he speaks about in Ephesians chapter 5, wives, submit to your husbands, but the reality to that is right before the verse before that says, submit to Christ. Submit to each other out of reverence for Christ. That's a great role, that we are actually in submission to Christ. That we are not this rung down, but actually we are in a role that's a servant to Christ. And so this gentleness, this meekness, this submissive role, this fruit of the Spirit, is to know our role of being a servant of our Master. The Spirit gives us the fruit of gentleness, to know our position, to know that we are a creation and there is a creator. And the fruit of the Spirit gives us and breathes inside of us to know who we are. Submissive, a servant, a slave, as Paul would say in his epistles, to Christ Jesus. That's not a negative connotation. That's a beautiful role to play. The one who came and was submissive to the Father and completed the mission and was a servant, the suffering servant, came to us, lived, died, rose, now gives authority to us, now gives his Spirit to us so that we too can be a servant of the Father, so that we could be light and salt in this world, so that we could be submissive to his will rather than walking in power and authority of our sin. That's what we would do, as it says in those verses just prior to the fruit of the Spirit. I'll read it again. It says, so that you do not do what you want in verse 17. So that you do not do what you want. What we would want to do is these sinful desires, these passions and these lusts for being able to just be sinful, because that's what we are by nature. But the Spirit of God has penetrated into our hearts. Now we have the fruit of the Spirit. Now we can know our role, that we've been called to be servants, that we've been called to just do the will of the Father rather than the will of my nature, because we've crucified those sins because of what Christ has crucified for us. He has done away with sin, death, and the power of the devil, and to given us his Spirit to know our role, that we just don't do what we want to do. Now we do what God wants us to do. A spirit of gentleness, meekness, playing a submissive role. How incredible it is to be in that role, because then we're not just thinking and trying to act upon what we do. No, we're just in God's Word and praying to the Spirit of God. Align us to God's will. Align us to the mission of the Father. We just want to be a servant. We just want to be submissive to what God is doing in and through us and in our world for the kingdom of God. The fruit of the Spirit is gentleness, meekness, being a servant of the Most High God. So as we begin this week, think about how gentleness, how you can be that gentleness, fruit of gentleness, in your life. The Spirit of God puts it inside of us. He puts us in our place so that we can just go about our role in the place of the kingdom of God by the power of Jesus Christ that is in us, through us, and giving of his Spirit. Have a blessed day being gentle, being meek, knowing your role in the kingdom of God. Have a blessed day.